Hey everybody, what's up? Good morning. It is about 9 a.m. and I've actually been up for a little while. Was up rather late too. This morning I really wanted to watch This Week with George Stephanopoulos. I usually watch that program on Sunday mornings. And today I watched it for a number of reasons. They're going to be talking about Obama's plan to bring health care to universal health care. And Bob Dole was on, Maxine Waters was on, Tom Daschle was on, and I can't remember the guy's name from Indiana. Which is really not, actually it is important, because when I think about, first of all, let's go back to, this is the first administration, the first president who has done such, I think, an outstanding job of just getting Americans talking about healthcare reform, something that truly needs to take place in this country. He is the first president that has said, you know what, let's try to address people who don't have insurance, and I commend him for that. I also want to say that I think he's doing an awesome job. When I see these polls say Americans don't approve of the president, I'm like, who are you asking? Because you didn't ask me. You didn't ask people that I know. Who are you asking? When we think about things that, everything that's going wrong in this country, it seems like Obama and his administration are being blamed for it, when the truth of the matter is, Bush created this shit. Bush created this mess. And now, it's like, there's a black man in office and it's gotta be hocus pocus, fix it. Well, it doesn't work that way. And it's gotta be, okay, everything's already screwed up. Nothing can fall apart any further. Well, it wasn't just gonna stop just because Obama took office. It was already set in motion. It was like a locomotive on a track. And the Obama administration are now the brakes on that locomotive that's out of control. So they're applying the brakes. They're trying their best to slow it down without causing too much more damage. And I think sometimes I think all the time when I watch the news, it just seems like the news media is making it seem like Obama has created this and his administration has created this, and it's his fault that this country is in the predicament that it's in, when the real truth of the matter is Bush did this. 8 years of his administration did this. So let's talk about the insurance reform. When I had money and when I was able to afford health insurance, I had Blue Cross of California. And it was pretty good insurance. I remember I started out with an HMO when I was like 18 years old. I started out when I left my parents' plan and then went to an HMO. I started with something called HealthNet, and I don't think HealthNet is around anymore, and I was just unhappy with how things were, how I had to always get approval to do things, but I had these astronomical co-pays, and then I switched to a company called Care America, because my employer forced me into choosing Care America. And it was another HMO, and I was just unhappy with it. I couldn't even see, I was paying out-of-pocket costs because I wanted to keep the doctors that I had. And they did not take Care America. So I was basically paying for insurance that I couldn't use, and then paying for doctor's visits. So then I switched to Blue Cross, because that's when my my catering business started taking off, and switched to Blue Cross. And I did like Blue Cross very, very much. And in a lot of ways, I wish I still had them, because I just didn't have to deal with a whole bunch of crap the way that I did with HMOs, and the way that I'm currently dealing with a whole bunch of crap now under a system that just doesn't work. So when I think about a universal healthcare or a healthcare plan with a public option, I'm just like, wow, that might be affordable for me. It won't eliminate me for pre-existing conditions. It won't eliminate, I mean, come on. I've got some pre-existing conditions. Cancer, sickle cell, HIV. Who's going to insure me? And who's going to insure me at a rate that I can afford? And I've been watching the town hall meetings, and I've been watching the debates, and all I see are these corporate execs or people who have good jobs, excuse me, people that have good jobs standing up saying, don't mess with my healthcare, don't do this with my healthcare. And it's almost like they're saying, to hell with everybody else that does not have healthcare, don't screw with mine. And I just haven't seen anywhere where their healthcare will be affected. And it's almost like, it's almost like the way things are in this country. Screw the poor, or screw people who can't afford things our way, and don't try to give them things that we have. That's what I hear when I'm listening to this debate on healthcare. You don't hear too many voices saying things like, what about the millions of Americans that don't have health care, that don't have an opportunity to get to a doctor, that actually need to get to a doctor? What about those? And it's like people with jobs and stuff who have health care are saying, well, screw them. I don't care about them. I just care about mine. This morning, the rep from Indiana, the senator from Indiana, said that he wishes Americans could choose the way Congress chooses. They have all these different healthcare plans. They can choose across state lines, and things like that. And I mean, that it does. It makes their healthcare, it's competition. You could choose anywhere in the United States. Come on. But you have to be able to afford that. He's saying all Americans should be able to do that. Okay, even if I could do that, I still could not afford it. And no one seems to get that poor people aren't going to be able to afford buying across state lines. Shit, they can't even buy in their own state. So how is opening up buying insurance across state lines from insurance companies that already discriminate for pre-existing conditions, that already have these astronomical co-pays, how is that going to be an answer to the millions of Americans that do not have health insurance? That just does not make sense to me. I am someone who is very dependent on, one, Ryan White funds, which are in jeopardy of being cut at the end of this month. So, there's a video called Save the Date, Make the Call. Make sure you guys make the call to get Ryan White funds extended. And if it wasn't for those funds, I wouldn't be able to currently see my doctor. So a public option is something that I definitely need. I'm a poor American, and I need health insurance. Medi-Cal here in the state of California says, I'm not sick enough. I have to be an AIDS patient before. And yes, there is a difference between someone who is HIV positive and someone who has AIDS. And I just want to be clear on that, because so many people are saying to me, well, what's the difference between HIV and AIDS? There is no difference. They're both the same. They are not the same. I'm HIV positive. I do not have AIDS. Let's be clear about that. But I got a little sidetracked. A public option would be awesome for me. I may not be able to afford it either. But the fact of the matter that it's actually there once I'm able to afford it is awesome. And I just don't understand this debate, how Obama is just getting beat up on the issue of trying to provide coverage to Americans. Universal health care is what we need. Peace and blessings.